John de Vries joins us now from Black Rock Mining. John, we of course took note of the announcement this morning on your major agreement with Taihe Soar. Can you tell us all about this?
Thank you, Daniel, and welcome to 2019. It's been a busy Christmas for us. We've been working in the Chinese market securing further offtake, and with this latest offtake with Taihe Soar, effectively gives us a three-year agreement that ramps up to 100,000 tonnes per annum of concentrate. That effectively means that BlackRock has sold out our definitive feasibility study module one, and a fair portion of module two is now spoken for as well. So we're delighted to have achieved that very, very significant milestone. I think importantly, that milestone would not have been achievable if we hadn't committed to running that very large pilot plant that we'd done during the definitive feasibility study. That gave us product that we could put in front of customers, and we could have meaningful conversations with customers, and clearly being able to secure a bit over 200,000 tonnes of offtake now is a very large milestone. In fact, it's the biggest offtake in the sector. So we're delighted, and it took a few days after Christmas to arrive, but we're happy it's got here.
So in addition to the pilot plant, what else are you doing differently from other promising graphite miners out there? We do understand you're looking more at this channel strategy as opposed to the peer-to-peer model. Can you explain what this means?
Yeah, look, our definitive feasibility study was very much driven by our understanding of the market. We put a lot of effort into marketing as part of the definitive feasibility study. We came out with two key aspects out of that. One is that the EV space is pretty crowded. There's a lot of people out there with product trying to get into the EV space, but that tends to be fairly fine material, and it's dominated particularly by the Chinese, so certainly it's a contested market. I'd probably describe that more as demand constrained. What we have found is that there is a very large demand for large, high purity flake, which fortunately is the dominant product that we produce. And that goes out into the expanded market, and there's a significant demand in that, and the fact that we've been able to secure a bit over 200,000 tonnes of offtake now certainly reinforces that the demand is real and it's a very large market. What we've done differently with Taihe Soar is that a lot of graphite developers and us as well have gone peer-to-peer, and that is we've targeted the larger customers because we can at least manage those people and we can form relationships. But there's a plethora of smaller people out there who simply we can't get to because it's too hard or they're too small. So where Taihe Soar comes in is they're a distributor. They want to work as a distributor for us. So we're going to work with them and put them in the position of a distributor, and it opens up an entirely new market that no Western graphite developer has addressed before. So we're very excited by that. And importantly, you know, it's not going to impact our margins because the smaller guys, by definition, end up paying a little bit more, which covers the sort of margins that a distributor would want to attract in that space. So we think it's fantastic. It opens up a new market for us, and it just reinforces the work that we did in the DFS that it's definitely market driven, and having that product available reinforced that it was a good decision.
Given that you have substantially sold out the DFS, how does this affect your plans for the Mahenge project in Tanzania?
Well, it puts us in a really good position. We're the only graphite developer at the moment that has a bankable level feasibility study. So, you know, we've got that now. There are a couple other people who've been sent back to the start line to do a DFS, which they're working on. But ours is ready to roll, and subject to finance and subject to the procedural granting of a mining license, we're effectively shovel ready and ready to roll. So we're very confident as we move into 2019 that we'll be working the finance markets equally as hard as we've worked the offtake markets, and I expect a pretty good outcome in that space in the not too distant future. What it means for us in the project, effectively, we need to go back and have a look at a schedule now to see if we can compress our development schedule and see if we can squeeze in a fourth module, because clearly the demand sits out there, and you know, if people want to buy your product, you certainly want to secure that market space as soon as possible. So that's the next item on the shopping list.
Do you have any sort of timelines for these major milestones moving forwards for your investors?
Well, we've always said that we wanted to have boots on the ground by the start of the dry season in Tanzania. So that's sort of May, June, and everything I'm seeing at the moment still has me confident that we'll have the finance in place and we'll be in a position to have boots on the ground and you know, have started some form of construction at the start of the dry season in Tanzania. So it'd be May, June is our target for commencement of on-ground activities. And I'm confident we're going to be there and doing that very quickly. The way we see it, you know, this is the year of the pig, and this time Bracklock's going to bring home the bacon.
John de Vries, thank you very much.